Thank you. Assalamu alaikum. Ya Rasulullah Tawrahtu alayhi asadu salamu alaykum. Walika sabika ajma'in asadu salamu alaykum. Ya Ambi Allah. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده
ربنا ولك الحمد
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا ولك الحمد.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا ولك الحمد.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا ولك الحمد.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
لا إله إلا الله.
مسبب الأسباب، يا مفتح الأبواب، يا مقلب القلوب والأبصار، يا دليل المتحيرين، يا غياث المستغيثين، يا حي يا قيوم، يا ذو الجلال والإكرام، مفوض أمري إلى الله، إن الله بصير بالعباد. الفاتحة.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Sheikh Nur John. Thank you for watching the video that you're watching. Inshallah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people. and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Eastern cultures use teas and herbs as an elixir of health and wellness. Rumi Rose Teas revives this ancient tradition with a collection of over 40 delicious hand-blended teas. Enjoy God-given health and wellness within every cup of Rumi Rose Tea. Order online now. A Timeless Reality with Sheikh Nurjan Mirahmadi guides the reader in meditation, connecting the heart to a guide and to daily spiritual practices to understand the effects of positive and negative energy and to progress the reader in their spiritual awakening and the soul's connection to the world of light. The Divine's Ancient Timeless Reality. Order on Amazon.com. Could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations go. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of divinely knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Sheikh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input. And with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, NurMuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Sheikh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been providing basic necessities to those most in need worldwide. There have been over 600 water wells established in rural communities across Pakistan already. We continue to support and maintain multiple orphanages, providing a safe haven for hundreds of orphans, encouraging a pleasant environment for them to flourish. There are now multiple food vans operating across many cities worldwide, with our many volunteers ensuring the needs of the most vulnerable are met. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings and go to MuslimCharity.com. Are you ever searching for what zikr to recite for a particular need? We bring to you the Muhammadan Way app, an all-encompassing Islamic guide, where you can find special du'as and prayers, as well as comprehensive Islamic teachings. Download this powerful app now on iOS and Android. Rising Sun of the West is an essential spiritual guidebook filled with invaluable knowledge of the soul.
in the Divine's most powerful guiding light, Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. The author guides the student through a comprehensive program of spiritual development and hidden realities of the soul. Available worldwide at Amazon.com.
As heavenly beings, we are on an eternal pursuit of angelic power. This book invites the seeker to attune to the guides of heavenly knowledge and discover the essential techniques we need to acquire to increase our positive energy within. In Pursuit of Angelic Power, available now on Amazon.com. Levels of the Heart, Lataif Al-Kalb, by Sheikh Nurjan Mirahmadi. There are subtle energies and realities that are addressing the heart. This unique masterpiece invites readers from all faiths to step forward and begin the process of unveiling the true spiritual realities within their own hearts. Insan al-Kamil, by author and spiritual guide Sheikh Nurjan Mirahmadi, describes that in order to be known, the Divine created a sublime treasure for all of creation, the glorious light and soul of the Insan al-Kamil, Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Vast universes, including every particle in existence, came into manifestation through this all-encompassing ocean of perfection. Order on Amazon.com. Welcome to the Muhammadan Way YouTube channel, where you will begin to discover the realities of the Prophet, secrets of Holy Quran, spirituality and Islamic meditation, discover the magnificent realities of Islam, and learn how to protect yourself in this material world that is encompassed by dark energy. Discover secrets of technology and the unseen within, and uncover the power of media and its control, and how to navigate the end of days, with topics on death and the afterlife. Attain access to spiritual healing and attune yourself with the divine energy within. Please subscribe now.
Shall it be number 5? Allahumma salli wa sallim ala nabina Muhammad alayhi salam. Salatan tadumu wa tuhda ilayhi mamar al-layali wa tuladabam. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Inna fatahna laka fathan mubina liyaghfiraka Allahumma taqaddama min dhanbika wama ta'akhkhar wa yutimma ni'matahu 'alayka wa yahdiyaka siratan mustaqima wa yansuraka Allahu nasran 'aziza laqad ja'akum rasulun min anfusikum azizun 'alayhi ma antum harisun 'alaykum bil mu'minin raufur rahim. فإن تولوا فقل حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الفاتحة لنا ولكم يا حاضرون ووالدنا ووالدكم وأهلنا وأولادنا ولمشايخنا ولمن حضرنا ولمن غاب عنا ولأحيائنا ولأمواتنا وللمواظبين على هذا المجلس ولمن كان سببا في جمعنا بأن الله الكريم ينبر القلوب ويغفر الذنوب ويستر العيوب ويحفظنا بما حفظ به الذكر وينصرنا بما نصر به الرسول وأن الله الكريم يجعل مجلسنا هذا محاطا بالخيرات والمسرات والأنوار والبركات ويقضي لنا جميع الحاجات بجاه خير البريات وأن الله ينصر المسلمين وعلى نيتنا الله الكريم ينصر سلطان الأولياء مولانا الشيخ محمد ناظم عادل حقاني قدس الله سره بجاه خير الأنام وعلى كل نية صالحة مع حسن الخاتمة عند الموت بعد عمر المديد في طاعة الله وإلى حضرة النبي.
الفاتحة. الشهادة للرسول الكريم والحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ومولانا محمد المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم مددكم من نظركم سيدي يا رسول الكريم يا حبيب العظيم مدد يا سيدي يا سلطان العليا من شيخ عبد الفايز الدغستاني سلطان الشيخ محمد ناظم الحقاني مولانا شيخ الشام كباني شيخ عدنان كباني شيخ محمد العادل عبد الخالق الخشتواني صاحب زمان سيد محمد المهدي عليه السلام روح الله سيدنا عيسى عليه السلام سيف الله سيدنا علي السلام ثم سيدنا أبو بكر الصديق سيدنا عمر سيدنا عثمان إمام الحسن السلام إمام الحسين السلام سيداتنا فاطمة الزهراء السلام سائر ساداتنا وصدقنا الفاتحة. الشهادة يا رسول آمين يا رب العالمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أنت سلطاننا يا ربنا اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا وزد حبيبك سيد الأولين والآخرين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم زده يا ربي عزا وشرافا ونورا وسرورا وسلطانا ورضوانا رملا في الشيطان ومن تبعه. عباد الله رجال الله أغيثونا بأهل الله وكونوا عوننا في الله أسان هذا بفضل الله ويا أقطاب ويا أنجاب ويا سادات ويا أحباب وأنتم يا أولي الألباب تعالوا وان سروا لله عباد الله رجال الله أغيثونا بأهل الله وكونوا عوننا في الله أسان هذا بفضل الله سألناكم سألناكم ولذو الفرجوناكم وفي أمر قصدناكم فشدوا أمركم لله عباد الله رجال الله أغيثونا بأهل الله وكونوا عوننا في الله أسى نهضا
بفضل الله
فيا ربي بساداتي تحقق لي إشاراتي أسى تاتي بشاراتي ويسفو أمرنا لله عباد الله رجال الله أغيثونا
بأهل الله
وكونوا عوننا في الله سنهضى
بفضل الله
بكشف الحجب عن عيني ورفع البين من بيني وصرف القلب والعين بنور الوجه يا الله عباد الله رجال الله أغيثونا بأهل الله وكونوا عوننا في الله عسى نهضى
بفضل الله
صلاة الله مولانا على من بالهدى جانا ومن بالحق أولانا شفي الخلق عند الله عباد الله رجال الله أغيثونا بأهل الله وكونوا عوننا في الله أسى نهضى بفضل الله مدد 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 يا سيدي مدد 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 يا رسول الله مدد يا أبو بكر الصديق مدد يا عمر فاروق مدد يا عثمان غني مدد يا إمام علي مدد 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 يا سيد مدد 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 يا رسول الله مدد يا فاطمة زهرة مدد يا إمام حسن مدد يا إمام حسين مدد يا سلمان فارسي مدد 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 يا سيد مدد 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 يا رسول الله مدد يا قاسم مدد يا صادق مدد يا بستامي مدد يا خرقاني مدد 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 يا سيد مدد
مدد مدد مدد
مدد يا رسول الله مدد يا فرمادي مدد يا همداني مدد يا خضار مدد يا غدواني مدد يا عارف مدد يا فغنوي مدد 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 يا سيد مدد 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 يا رسول الله مدد يا رميتاني مدد یا سماسی مدد یا امیر کولال مدد یا شاہ نقشبند مدد یا عطارو مدد یا چارخی مدد 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 یا سید مدد 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 مدد
مدد
یا رسول الله مدد یا احراری مدد یا زاهدی مدد یا درویشو مدد یا انکنکی مدد یا بقی بالله مدد یا سر هندی مدد 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 یا سید مدد 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 یا رسول الله مدد یا معصومی مدد یا سیف الدین مدد یا بدوانی مدد یا شمس الدین مدد یا دهلوی مدد یا بغدادی مدد 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 یا سید مدد 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 مدد
مدد
یا رسول الله مدد یا اسماعیل مدد یا خاص محمد مدد یا راغی مدد یا غمقی مدد 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 یا سید مدد 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 یا رسول الله مدد یا صغوری مدد یا مدنی مدد یا شرف الدین مدد یا عبد الله مدد مدد مدد
یا سید
مدد 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 یا رسول الله مدد یا شیخ ناظم مدد یا شیخ شام مدد یا شیخ عدنان مدد یا شیخ خادم مدد 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 یا سید مدد 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 مدد
مدد
یا رسول الله مدد یا صاحب الوقت مدد یا فردانی مدد یا صدیق مدد یا یمنی مدد یا امام العارفین مدد یا سخاوی مدد یا مرد ملحان مدد یا غسلانا مدد 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 یا سید مدد 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 مدد
مدد
یا رسول الله مدد یا امام مهدی مدد یا خلیفة الله مدد یا امام مهدی مدد یا خلیفة الله مدد 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 یا سید مدد 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 یا رسول الله
شال اردو کوالی بک پیج 17
اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ یہ گھرانہ برا البرا ہے اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ یہ گھرانہ برا البرا ہے اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ یہ گھرانہ ورا البرا ہے اس میں حسنین ہے فاطمہ ہے اس میں حسنین ہے فاطمہ ہے اس گھرانے میں مشکل کشا ہے اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ یہ گھرانہ ورا البرا ہے لب ہے تذکیر پنجتر کے پھول مہکے ہیں میرے چمن کے لب ہے تذکیر پنجتر کے پھول مہکے ہیں میرے چمن کے ایسا ان کے کرم نے نوازا ایسا ان کے کرم نے نوازا اپنی قسمت پہ دل جھومتا ہے اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ یہ گھرانہ ورا البرا ہے امتی ہوں میں شاہ زمن کا ہوں بھکاری میں آقا حسن کا امتی ہوں میں شاہ زمن کا ہوں بیکاری میں آقا حسن کا صدقے جاؤں میں ان کی عطا پر صدقے جاؤں میں ان کی عطا پر دینے والے نے سب کچھ دیا ہے اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ یہ گھرانہ ورا البرا ہے نام پر تیرے سب کچھ ملا ہے نام پر تیرے سب کچھ فدا ہے نام پر تیرے سب کچھ ملا ہے نام پر تیرے سب کچھ فدا ہے نام پر تیرے قربان جاؤں نام پر تیرے قربان جاؤں ہم غریبوں کا تو آسرا ہے اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ یہ گھرانہ ورا البرا ہے خیر سے تم ہی خیر البرا ہو اور تم ہی سید الانبیاء ہو خیر سے تم ہی خیر البرا ہو اور تم ہی سید الانبیاء ہو کوئی تجھ سا ہوا ہے نہ ہوگا کوئی تجھ سا ہوا ہے نہ ہوگا تیرے رب کا یہی فیصلہ ہے اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ یہ گھرانہ ورا البرا ہے میرا بھی ہے کوئی دنیا والوں بے سہارا مجھے تم نہ سمجھو میرا بھی ہے کوئی دنیا والوں بے سہارا مجھے تم نہ سمجھو ساتھ میرے میرا پیشوا ہے ساتھ میرے میرا پیشوا ہے میرا رب ہے میرا مصطفیٰ ہے اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ
یہ گھرانہ وراؤن ورا ہے،
لاج رکھ لو گدائے کرم کی، بھر دو ہماری بھی جھولی، لاج رکھ لو گدائے کرم کی، بھر دو ہماری بھی جھولی، کوئی یہ نہ کہے کملی والے، کوئی یہ نہ کہے کملی والے، تیری محفل سے خالی گیا ہے، اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ، یہ گھرانہ ورا البرا ہے، کعبہ عشق کا ہوں نمازی، میں ہوں ال کی عنایت پہ راضی، کعبہ عشق کا ہوں نمازی، میں ہوں ان کی عنایت پہ راضی، میری تربت پہ لکھنا نیازی،
سب کی تربت پہ لکھنا نیازی،
پنج تن کا یہ ادنا گدا ہے، اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ، اللہ اللہ نبی کا گھرانہ، یہ گھرانہ ورا البرا ہے، اس میں حسنین ہے فاطمہ ہے، اس میں حسنین ہے فاطمہ ہے، اس گھرانے میں مشکل کشا ہے،
page 29.
Allah سبحان اللہ ما اجمل کا ما احسن کا ما اکمل کا، سبحان اللہ ما اجمل کا ما احسن کا ما اکمل کا، کتھے مہر علی کتھے تیرے سنا، کتھے مہر علی کتھے تیرے سنا، مشتاق اکھی کتھے جالنیاں، اللہ 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 اللہ
اللہ اللہ
اللہ، محبوب دمیلائے محبوب دمیلائے محبوب دمیلائے، محفل نو سجائے رکھنا، محفل نو سجائے رکھنا، او دے آن دا ویلا ہے، اللہ 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 اللہ، رحمت دا مہینہ ہے، رحمت دا مہینہ اے، رحمت دا مہینہ ہے، لوکاں دیاں لکھ ٹھاراں، لوکاں دیاں لکھ ٹھاراں، ساڈی ٹھار مدینہ ہے، اللہ 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 اللہ
اللہ اللہ
اللہ، دسا گل کی خزینے دی، دسا گل کی خزینے دی، دسا گل کی خزینے دی، دنیا کھاندی اے، دنیا کھاندی اے، خیرات مدینے دی، اللہ 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 کوئی مثل نہ ڈھولن دی کوئی مثل نہ ڈھولن دی کوئی مثل نہ ڈھولن دی چپ کر مہر علی چپ کر مہر علی ایتھے جا نہیں بولن دی اللہ 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 اللہ
اللہ
اللہ اللہ
اللہ اللہ الصلاۃ والسلام علیک یا رسول اللہ الصلاۃ والسلام علیک یا حبیب اللہ الصلاۃ والسلام علیک یا رسول اللہ الصلاۃ والسلام علیک یا حبیب اللہ الصلاۃ والسلام علیک یا نبی اللہ الصلاۃ والسلام علیک یا نبی اللہ الصلاۃ والسلام علیک یا نور اللہ 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 اللہ
اللہ اللہ اللہ
اللہ اللہ حسبنا اللہ ونعم الوکیل نعم المولا ونعم النصیر حسبنا اللہ ونعم الوکیل نعم المولا ونعم النصیر اللہ 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 اللہ
اللہ
اللہ اللہ اللہ اللہ حسبی ربی جل اللہ ما فی قلبی غیر اللہ حسبی ربی جل اللہ ما فی قلبی غیر اللہ نور محمد صلی اللہ نور محمد صلی اللہ حق لا الہ الا اللہ 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 اللہ
اللہ
اللہ اللہ اللہ
اللہ
علی نو یاد کرو رل کے فریاد کرو علی نو یاد کرو رل کے فریاد کرو ہے غریباں دا اے ہو آسرا علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم 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 لکھ تے کروڑ واری آنکھو جم جم علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم 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 نبی دا پیارا علی نور علی نور علی دا ہے اللہ اللہ کا بچ ظہور علی مولا علی مولا علی مولا علی علی
علی مولا او دے جندے مولا نے حضور
علی پیر پیران دا ہے دلان دا سرور علی مولا علی مولا علی مولا علی علی
ولیاں دے سیران
دا ہے تاج علی علی مومنا دی بس ہے میرا جلی علی ولیاں دے سرا دا ہے تاج علی علی مومنا دی بس ہے میرا جلی علی گن گن دسا کنے علی دے کرم علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم علی مولا
علی مولا
علی دم دم علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم
علی دی پچھانے رب دی پچھان علی دیا طاقتاں نو جان دا جہان
علی مولا علی مولا علی مولا علی علی رب دا ہے شیر علی علی دی ہے شان گل دے ایمان علی نبی دا اعلان علی مولا علی مولا علی مولا علی علی حیدر قرار بتراب علی علی ہاشمی چراغ لا جواب علی علی حیدر قرار بتراب علی علی ہاشمی چراغ لا جواب علی علی جنہ دا نہ کوئی علی دا برم
علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم
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 لکھ تے کروڑ واری آکھو جم جم
علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم 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 سوچا تے تخیلن دا تارا علی علی بڑی شان نبی دے بعد علی 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 عاشقاں لئی نور دا مینار علی علی پائے منگ دین سب امداد علی دی غما دے طوفان چ کنارا علی علی بھاری میں کی دساں رو داد علی دی دکھیاں دے دلاں دا سہارا علی علی عبادت این عبادت یاد علی نبی دے نور دی تنویر حیدر شجاعت دا پیکر کون حیدر کتاب عشق دی تفسیر حیدر فتح کر دا اے خیبر کون حیدر
گن گن دسا کن علی دے کرم
علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم
لکھ تے کروڑ واری آکھو جم جم
علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم علی مولا علی مولا علی دم دم
پیج 40 نبی کا ذکر ہے خدا کا ذکر ہے نبی کا ذکر ہے خدا کا ذکر ہے نبی کی بات ہی خدا کی بات ہے ید اللہ کہہ دیا تو ثابت ہو گیا ید اللہ کہہ دیا تو ثابت ہو گیا نبی کا ہاتھ ہی خدا کا ہاتھ ہے نبی کا ذکر ہی صلی علی نبینا صلی علی محمد صلی علی شفیعنا صلی علی محمد ہم پہ ایسی عطا ہے نبی کی بھول جائیں گے کیسے ہم کو خطرے ڈرائیں گے کیسے پاس آئیں گے کیسے یہ آنکھیں نم نہیں کوئی بھی غم نہیں یہ آنکھیں نم نہیں کوئی بھی غم نہیں کرم حضور کا ہمارے ساتھ ہے نبی کا ذکر ہے صلی علی نبینا صلی علی محمد شفیعنا صلی علی محمد. ان کے صدقے ہی میں ہیں کہ ہوئے ہیں دو جہاں کے نظارے، ان کے فیض کرم سے ہے روشن کہکشاں اور ستارے. یہ ساری روشنی، یہ ساری دلکشی، یہ ساری روشنی، یہ ساری دلکشی میرے نبی کے حسن کی زکات ہے. نبی کا ذکر ہے، صلی علی نبینا صلی علی محمد، صلی علی شفیعنا صلی علی محمد. بے حمل ہوں مگر میرے آقا، نظر رحمت کریں گے میرے جیسے گناہ گار کی بھی وہ شفاعت کریں گے. بڑے عظیم ہیں، بڑے کریم ہیں، بڑے عظیم ہیں، بڑے کریم ہیں، وہ جن کے ہاتھ میں میری نجات ہے. نبی کا ذکر ہے، صلی علی نبینا صلی علی محمد، صلی علی شفیعنا صلی علی محمد. وہ جو کہہ دے وہ ہو کے رہے گا، یہی کہتا ہے قرآن. ان کا فاروق زندہ ہے فرما، یہ ہمارا ہے ایمان. اگر وہ دل کہے تو راتیں دل بنے، اگر وہ دل کہے تو راتیں دل بنے، کہے وہ دل کو رات تو وہ رات ہے. نبی کا ذکر ہی، صلی علی نبینا صلی علی محمد، صلی علی شفیعنا صلی علی محمد، صلی علی نبینا صلی علی محمد، صلی علی شفیعنا صلی علی محمد.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله يا شرف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى أصحابه الكرام وعلى مشايخنا في طريقة الأشبندية العليا وسائر وسادتنا والصديقين. الفاتحة. آمين يا رب العالمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أطيع الله أطيع الرسول أولي الأمر منكم. And always a reminder for myself. أنا عبدك العاجي الضعيف مسكين ظالم الجهل. But for the grace of Allah that we're still in existence. And alhamdulillah, this is a this weekend, alhamdulillah, blessed month, Rabbi Thani, and immense light towards the reality of Sayyidina Muhammad in the 45th Surah Jathiya, inshaAllah bringing us into the kingdom and to the immense realities that Allah is a hidden treasure wanting to be known, and known by the best of creation, the best character, the best example and most praised one. In Divinely Presence, Sayyidina Muhammad. best of those to emulate, to copy and to follow as an example and exemplars of faith, inshaAllah. This is our weekend to reflect and to go over what we've been teaching, inshaAllah, from all these different subjects. InshaAllah, what do we have for tonight?
As-salamu alaykum, Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Sayyidi, how could love and trust be built if 90% of people have intention to cause harm, as mentioned in the discussion yesterday?
Yeah, no, your sound is low, Shaykh, I can't hear.
Testing. Can you hear me?
Yeah, closer to the mic maybe, so I can hear.
As-salamu alaykum, Sayyidi.
Wa alaykum as-salam.
How could love and trust be built if 90% of the people have intention to cause harm, as mentioned in yesterday's discussion?
InshaAllah, love and trust in Allah means that these are the days in which to build our faith. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, amanu. That for anyone who thinks, oh, they believe, alhamdulillah for you, but keep believing. That we must go much deeper in our belief and keep pushing for a deeper belief, a deeper reliance upon Allah and upon our faith. So trust in only Allah and the love of Sayyidina Muhammad. And those who represent that love and represent and reflect that love by its actions, not by word. It means the one whom continuously teaching about that love and the reality of Sayyidina Muhammad is what's important. So if you go back to these teachings, you'll see that people talk about the last days, talk about the signs of last days. Talk about Juj and Majuj is hidden in this cave, this is this, this is this, this is this. And it's reality that only Allah come and teaches. All of that is what's the importance of all of that if you don't teach the key? If you don't teach people, the key is Muhammadun Rasulullah. Because that's the key that shaitan is going to try to take away. Knowing the alamat, knowing Qur'an by thinking they read it, they send the children to become hafiz, all of this fantastic if they understood the key is Muhammadun Rasulullah. For if that key should be taken from you, you're empty. Your faith will be dropped, your faith will be lost and the person will come under attack. So this is the key of the last days. So we see how that madhab that reflects the Dajjal's teachings, and that's the danger, is to talk much about Allah, much about Holy Qur'an, less about Sayyidina Muhammad and less about the hadith and Prophet described in last days, they won't even mention me on the minbar. And people who talk often about Allah but make no mention of Sayyidina Muhammad. How you can pretend to know Allah when you don't know even your name and yourself? And that you don't talk about the Rasul ﷺ. So that becomes the key. And those whom not talking about Prophet ﷺ, they're not a solution but they're more a part of the problem. And problems in the last days are so subtle that shaitan is going to fool people with good deeds. Outright bad is outright bad. So that's not what's going to fool believers and pull, you know, the card or the string out of the believer. The bad is outright bad, that's for a different category of people. But shaitan has to deal with these people and take away faith in such a subtle way in which they don't know their faith is being taken away. And that has to do with the key. So when you keep your eye on the key, keep your eye on the target, the reality is Muhammadun Rasulullah. And that's why the sunnah is so important, the way, the ish, the love, the teachings, all of that is keeping us to what Allah described, hold tight. Hold tight to hablillah. Habl and hub, same letters. That the Arabic for a rope has same letters as Arabic for hub and love, because you got to hold on to that rope with love, not with your aqal. Your mind, shaitan going to come and fool, oh, and give you very clever talks on why your mind is thinking the wrong thing. But love, it bonds in such an immense depth. So it means the heart that has a love for Prophet ﷺ, they adhere to it because of love. They do what they do because of love. They hold fast and struggle with their practices, their faith, and trying to outdo other people in their practices for the love and the attention of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, because competition is good in religion. If you don't feel that you're competing, you're doing something wrong. If you feel that it doesn't matter, who cares, you're doing something wrong. Because you have to feel competitive, you have to feel that you want the attention of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, so you want to do more. But now people have bizarre thought that they look left and right, say, they're not doing it, why should I do it? Well, because when Allah wants to come and put a difficulty on their grave, He's not going to be asking you and He's not burying you together. Everyone has their own grave. If you want your grave to be shiny, you want your grave to be filled with light, you want your life to be filled with barakah, you want the nazar and the attention of Prophet ﷺ, get up and rise up. Once you rise up and stand, you don't care about left and right, you don't care if everyone's sleeping, you have something to do and you have to do it. And you only can do that by love. Means that you have that immense love to make Prophet ﷺ happy with you, and that you want to exceed beyond others. If others are bringing five people, I'm going to bring 5,000 people. If other people are feeding 10 people, I want to feed 10,000 people. You have to feel a competition. That's the state in which we're yearning for to achieve. So our trust is only in Allah, His beloved Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, and as a result those whom represent that love. If they cease to represent that love, then at least our heart is connected to Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. That's the importance. As soon as we talk about love, a lot of people begin to talk about emotions, right? So female are emotional, men are physical. The state of love that we talk about is not emotional. Where you say, oh, Shaykh is talking so much about love, so I have to be kind to everyone, good to everyone, just not and trusting to everyone. No, 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 no. This is a, these are the last days in which Prophet ﷺ described the one sitting, means he's hiding, is better than the one standing. Don't go out. Sit where you are, do your ibadah, and you go for your work and come back. Means these are the difficulties that open. As soon as they open a door, they open confusion. So they stay within their cave, they do their practices, they go out to work, they come back and secure their faith. They live their life with khidmat and to be busy in the service of Allah, not the service of themselves. These are the medicine for every day there's a sickness and Allah provides its medicine. These teachings are the medicine for these days, not for 1,000 years ago but for today. The system of Dajjal coming upon this earth, his zuhur in which he wants to pronounce himself, they said coming 2023, if that figure is who they say he is, he must profess himself. Immediately he professes himself who he is, then there's certain actions he must take. That's their faith, it's not our faith, we're not saying we're that person. So when that individual claims who he is, immediately things begin to happen. As a result of seeing that, then we put our faith and trust in Allah as being dispensed and sent out to us by the guidance of our shuyukh and this immensely powerful Naqshbandi connection that guides us through the storm of everything they are planning on doing, everything that they have done and everything that they will do. And whatever they say they will do, they don't put into account Allah because they don't believe, they're Dajjal, shaitan. Shaitan had plans that we're going to inoculate this, we're going to do this, we're going to do all that. Yes, that was their intention, and within their plan Allah plans best, He wrote the program. And they weren't able to achieve that. So people whom are worried, put your faith and trust in Allah. Whatever they're planning, Allah has provided its escape, its safety and its cave. If Allah writes a shower of fire to come upon the earth, He also wrote within the program a cave of safety. That's why then the tawakkul and the love and the reliance is upon Allah. And that true reliance can only be found in the love and the ishq of Sayyidina Muhammad. That is the key, that is the secret of a'udhu billah, that if you want to seek refuge in Allah from shaitan, that was the beginning of every journey. Before you try to understand who is Bismillahir Rahmanir Raheem, then you had to be already in the presence of a'udhu billahi min shaitanir rajeem. Who is the reality of a'udhu billah? When Allah says, seek refuge in me from shaitan, not you go out and fight shaitan, but seek refuge in me, where is that refuge? That's in the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad. Those with their love and their sunnah and every good character they're trying to keep to the best of their ability with the overwhelming dirtiness of this dunya. As a result of that, they're brought near to the presence of Prophet ﷺ, and as a result then they are fulfilling what Allah asked, that seek refuge in me. Means that when you seek refuge in the presence of Prophet ﷺ, you are seeking refuge in me, and I am the protector of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. So when you're in that proximity and in that nearness, you're under the umbrella of protection. And even if the world is destined for a fire and a storm of fire from the skies, Allah has written within the program, there's a cave of safety, enter within it. They tried to do many things, it didn't work. They tried to collapse many things, it didn't work. So they'll continue to do what they think they want to do. But always within this program there's already a code and a secret that has been put within it. Its key is Muhammadun Rasulullah ﷺ. If you lose that key, that cave won't be visible to you and that safety won't be visible to you. as when they came to come against Sayyidina Muhammad وسلم, they went directly to the cave. They looked into the cave and then appeared a spider web and two birds guarding that reality. They looked but they did not see, because Allah described, they have eyes but they don't see. When Allah doesn't want somebody to see, they don't see. They have ears and they don't hear. You talk all you want and they're not going to hear us. So means Allah is the one whom is in complete control. Safety is the immense level of faith. That's why the one whom has doubt, better for them to go where you think you're going to be safe, and the testing become more difficult. And that's why they gave the example, Mawlana Sharafuddin, when they were coming to destroy the region, they said, oh, Mawlana, people are coming, what should we do? He said, plant your seeds, don't pay attention. And people got angry and they said 2/3 of them ran. So he doesn't know what he's talking about. We told them the armies are approaching to slaughter us. He said, go plant your seeds. And how many times we've given this example? Because they don't want people who are going to be panicking and through their brain yelling and screaming. So they ran. After they ran, the one whom stayed, they had immense faith. And as a result, he gave them something to recite from Surat al-Yaseen, that a barrier to be put in front of them, behind them, drink from this water and let's walk. And for groups of people, there are groups of shaykhs, not one shaykh. One shaykh may think he's the one shaykh for everything, but there's all this humanity that has to come to guidance. So each whom Allah give within their hearts a bonding, they feel attuned and their heart resonates, means they've already been partitioned to that shaykh on the Day of Promises. The souls resonate like armies and battalions. You can only be with whom you've been destined to be. As much as you try to be in another group, your heart doesn't resonate and you find yourself out and drifting. Means those whom have an uns and a familiarity, Prophet described, they're like battalions in the world of light. Means that you have eternally been with that shaykh, under that tarbiyah, under that guidance, so that your heart on this dunya resonates with them. Resonates with him. Adhere to the teaching, follow that way, and that guidance and that protection and those realities come out. So this is the reality of love, because as soon as you say love, people start interpreting everything they want through their head. This is very specific. This is the love of faith. This is the love of pleasing Allah, so that to be protected. You know, in dunya everybody wants so much to have the right insurance. You have a car, you want to make sure you have insurance. You don't try to cheat your insurance unless you want to shoot yourself in the foot, right? If you cheat your insurance and the day you get an accident, what happens? Oh yeah, that insurance you bought from that island that nobody knows, they don't cover anything. So you don't cheat yourself when you're getting insurance, because you need it on a day of difficulty. So the same with the shaykh and with the tariqah, you don't cheat anybody but yourself. On a day of difficulty, you didn't adhere to it, then what do you think you're going to benefit from it, you know? So this is this dunya is continuously teaching us about akhirah, that the things you do in dunya and the things that you take serious in your material world, well, multiply that by 1,000 for your spiritual. And that's importance, and that's why the spiritual path is very unique to the individual. They know if their policy is in effect, they know what they've put their heart and soul into it. They know that they've put what they can to participate and to do to stay under protection, and they can see the signs. These are not even esoteric teachings anymore. Esoteric were like when you didn't see anything wrong and you were told to believe days of difficulty are coming. Well, right now they're telling you on every social media contact they're going to wipe out all bank accounts around the world. If you thought the problem of a pandemic was something, imagine what's coming upon this earth. You know, if you thought the cold and the flu was a problem and people were going and taking every type of thing because they were losing their mind and they wanted to take 2, 3, 4, 5 different things. So it means difficulties are coming upon this earth and it requires faith, it requires faith. And to be under the umbrella and the love and the ishq of Sayyidina Muhammad and doing their awrad and wazifas, because Allah by guidance of Holy Qur'an says, I cannot punish them, I will not punish them while they're making istighfar and you are amongst them. And this becomes our najat and our salvation that only Allah, they're getting this from Prophet to train people, keep yourself in the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad do your istighfar, do your awrads and your zikrs so that Allah keeps us under the shade and the umbrella of safety inshaAllah through very difficult times inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum ya Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Can oneself leave the station of love to the station of presence?
What's that?
Can they leave from the station of love to the station of presence?
From the muhabbat the shaykh to the hudur, what was the question?
Yes Sayyidi, can oneself leave the station of love to the station of presence to walk towards my reality?
You have to get the meditation book. So the meditation book is teaching us these are three states that you have to have a love for this way for the teaching. If you don't love the shaykh, you're not going to listen to that teaching. This is not going to only make logical sense. So it means you have to have an affinity and a tune. That's what we just talked to before the question, is that your heart attunes to them. You say, I understand what he's talking about. A respect for this person, you begin to develop a love and admiration for that person and as a result you begin to meditate. So once you have the muhabbat, the hudur is the tafakkur. So the one whom is not meditating, not contemplating is not entering into the presence. And then they think that I want to get a ticket and go and spend 3 weeks there. That's not the state of the presence. The presence is that wherever you are, you meditate and contemplate that the shaykh is right in front of you and you're making your connection. And that you have to feel that connection and that your faith is like a mountain in which you fully believe within your heart you have that state, you feel that state, you feel the energy of that state and that your communication is in that world of light, that I feel the presence of the shaykh and I'm continuously talking to him asking, send light into my heart, send this light into my heart. Not physical matters, not the dunya things, I want this, I want that, that's only from your nafs and ego. That communication line is not for dunya, that communication line is only for spirituality. Once you use it for dunya, it's actually nafsani and that's then now illusional, it's not the presence of the shaykh but it's the presence of your nafs. That connection is for spirituality in which you connect And that Sayyidi, inspire within my heart to do more service, send your light into my heart, I'm nothing. And as a result fill my heart with energy and light. As soon as they meditate they feel energy, they feel their heart is collapsing, they feel every type of, you know, power and qudra coming through that. That's the only connection is necessary. That's the hudur. If they can achieve that and keep that hudur throughout the day, what happens? They're becoming and they're entering in the ocean of fana, in which they see less and less of themselves and they begin to vanish. And as a result of them vanishing, what is remaining is the presence of the shaykh. So that to leave yourself and let them to enter. When they can keep that, then they can enter into the presence of the shaykh, they be dressed from the presence of the shaykh and they begin to represent the shaykh. And they represent that reality, they represent the ears, because that hadith al-Qudsi in which Allah is describing, I become the hearing in which you hear, the seeing in which you see, that's an inheritable trait from Atiullah, Atiur Rasul, Ulul Amri Minkum. So means first you have to achieve it with ulul amr before you can achieve with Allah. So then with your voluntary madad and connection you become the hearing that the shaykh is giving to you. You're using his gift to hear, you use his gift to see, you use his gift to begin to speak from his oceans of wisdom. So that's the dress of the shaykh upon the person. So when you're dressed by the shaykh it comes with all of its realities, right? The dress of the shaykh is coming with this, with the gift of hearing, because not his physical ears, it's his spiritual ears. So when the spiritual light of the shaykh is dressing, what happens? You're now hearing from his hearing, and that's in degrees of how pure the person is training. You'll begin to see from their seeing and you begin to speak and breathe from that energy. When you realize that, then your adherence and bond with the shaykh is very strong, because if you do anything to break it you won't hear anything and you won't feel anything and you feel like you're in a closet. That's to remind people it's not from you, because the system can't work like that. It would be like Faraon. Imagine that Allah would train people by the shaykh and then give them some spiritual healing, then the guy gives you a screaming and a shout, a curse word to you and left. And now he's walking around with spiritual hearing and doing all sorts of mischief on the earth. So it's not anything like that. Allah understands this creation is very corrupt. So it's a dress that as soon as you keep the madad, the dress of the shaykh comes on to you. If you keep yourself to be clean, then you'll hear from his hearing, not from your hearing, you have no hearing. Because remember you said that you were nothing on this way. If you acknowledge that you were nothing, nothing can't have anything. So in your nothingness the dress comes, it becomes the hearing dress of the soul of the shaykh, the seeing dress from the soul of the shaykh, the feel from the soul of the shaykh. When the servant is able to keep that with good manners, good practices, keeping the trust in what's been dressing upon him or her with their good characters and adherence to the holy sunnah of Sayyidina Muhammad and the sharia of Allah, what happens now? Because the shaykh is in the presence of Prophet. When the tarbiyah of the student is correct, what happens? Now with the dress of the shaykh, he's in the dress of the shaykh. So now he's given an audience in where the shaykh is also present, which is what? Now muhabbat ar-Rasul wa hudur ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa fana'u ar-Rasul. Because you're in the dress of the shaykh is in the presence of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then that dress of the shaykh now sits in the presence with the shaykh in the presence of Prophet. when they keep their adherence in the sunnah of Sayyidina Muhammad means now Prophet begin to give from his holy dress upon their hearing, and they begin to hear with Prophet. They begin to see with Prophet. So then they have a Muhammadiyun dress. Well, where is Prophet sitting? In the presence of Allah. So with their Muhammadan dress that they become Muhammadiyun, they are now sitting in the presence of Allah. And they now understood that hadith from its reality, that Allah gives them a hearing, Allah gives them a seeing in which they hear what Allah wants them to hear, they see what Allah wants them to see, they breathe what Allah wants them to breathe, their hands have a qudra and a power from what Allah wants them to have power, because these are their dresses. But for someone thinking that they're going to just sit, meditate and now have Allah's dress, no, because it's Atiullah, Atiya Rasul wa ulul amri minkum. You have to obey Allah, you have to obey Prophet and you have to obey the ulul am. It's like a rope to you. You don't go to the top but you have to climb. So the rope's closest end to you is the ulul am, is the shaykh. So that's why then when I say I'm nothing, if you plan on walking away or doing anything bad, all vision will be cut, all hearing will be cut, all feeling will be cut, and if you were relying upon it, you feel like you're better off dead than walking this earth without that connection. Because the connection is so powerful and it is a their source of life for them. And that's why we said the person whom has no connection, they have no understanding of what taqwa is. Somebody behind 7 feet of steel, what he knows about taqwa? They have no fear of Allah, they have no understanding of Allah. The one whom has fear, and it's not a fear of punishment anymore, it's the fear of immense love that Allah dressing them. And they don't want to lose that dress, they keep themselves clean, they keep their eyes clean, they keep their mannerism clean, they don't abuse the power they have, the energy they have, otherwise immediately that dress will be taken off. And that's the way they safeguard this reality, nobody ever runs away with it. So anybody who has it, they have it because they're sanctified and certified. There's no way to run away with it because it's a dress from the shaykh. As long as he keeps that dress upon that person, they are the dress of the shaykh and they represent the shaykh with his hearing and with his seeing, with his speaking, with his breath, with his hands and with his feet, and they are muqaddam of the shaykh. Depending upon which shaykh, so people can't guess who the shaykh is. But the reality is the dress of that reality, and that shaykh then is placed in always in the presence of Prophet. So we get an understanding of the importance of that dress and why the muraqabah is that door, and that's the people of tafakkur, that's the people of Ashab al-Kahf. The whole theme from Muharram this year has been pretty intense and very detailed. Because of the events that are coming. So this cave is becoming very clear, very defined, and people should be moving quickly into it, inshaAllah.
As Salaamu Alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum As Salaam wa rahmatullah.
Related to the talk on the circumference and the radius, does it mean that the radius journey to the point is fana after fana? Please forgive this student.
Yeah, it's a that's like philosophy stuff. That you'll know what fana is when you entered into fana. But the main understanding is that if you live your life on the circumference, you'll know nothing. and your life will be all circumstantial, all dunya oriented. As soon as you take your tariqah, you listen, you get your books, you take your notes, you start to do your zikr, you're a student. Now you can be in tariqah and say, I've been sitting there 20 years, I come, I go and I eat, I have dinner with them and I leave. That's not tariqah, that's somebody of muhibbin. That they loved it, they enjoyed it, they had dinner and they went home. That's a something different dress. But the ones and the students of the way is the one whom came to reach their reality. That they came to serve, they came to draw near to Prophet ﷺ, and they live it as their life, that it's everything to them. They want to learn, they want to reach to a reality, and they want the proximity to the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. So this is the difference. As a result, every step they're taking on their tariqah, well those are the steps. So what the step equals? What? Learning. If you didn't learn anything after 15 years, they'd like sit you down and ask you a couple questions and you don't know what I'm talking about. But then that was just the barakah for you, you ate good food and inshaAllah Allah dress you from the blessings of the zikr. That didn't mean you were stepping. The one whom stepping means he took a qadam, he took his path, he's asking his feet to inherit from his shaykh's feet, to exemplify the way of the shaykh so that his feet can take the path of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. So there's one whom stepped and then stopped. But the one whom continuously stepping means they're learning, they're learning, they're learning, they're taking now steps towards their marifah. They're learning the reality, they learn the path, they go out and they're of service to the path, so they're continuously stepping. So as they step with this love and with this ishq, if they're meditating and doing their tafakkur, they're entering in infinite states of fana. So that's why we described the fana already. A fana is a state in which you empty yourself of yourself. That way the shaykh can begin to dress you from the reality. And then Allah opened for the servant their hal and khash. These are two states for the seeker, hal and khash, not dreams. Because somebody who's standing on the circumference has dreams. Every grandmother has dreams. Everyone on the circumference has dreams. That's not this way. The one whom stepping, struggling, fighting with themselves, Allah opens for them hal. So what's their hal? Hal means a state in which they're breathing, meditating in the zikr. It can come at any time, Allah wants to send it, immediately they're overtaken by an energy, by a feeling, by crying, that the subtlety of the breeze that hits them can make them laugh, cry, enter into an ecstasy because of the softness and subtlety within their heart. As they're moving closer into that fire, the fire begins to dress them, the Divinely fire, Divinely grace. Immediately they can enter into hal, the one whom becomes sahib al-hal, the one whom owns that state is very near to the proximity in which continuously the flame of Divine ishq comes into them and overwhelms them. So the farther you are from that flame, the less effect it has onto you, right? So that's what we described, the circumference person dreams a lot. Because on the circumference, they're really not coming too much into the depth of the… inside. As they start to move, you're getting closer to the flame, and the flame is now controlling you, burning within you, guiding you, sending its flares. Have you seen the sun? Has flares. So imagine the center is the most powerful sun of all suns ever created, and we're just an outside planet asking to lose our form and to become a star. And as you start stepping in, if you crush and lose your form, the light of you will become more prominent than the mass of you, and now you're becoming like a star on the radius, no longer just a form on the circumference. So you're now a star that's progressing. If you're a light and a little sun, because awliya are like suns, the more that you're moving to the center, what happens? The greater sun is sending you all sorts of flares, which are immense energies, tajallis, all these emanations. You can visualize it now with my examples. So Najm al-Thaqib, Allah gave examples of stars in Holy Qur'an, the piercing star. So Najm al-Thaqib is in the center. Then when you read about Najm al-Thaqib, Allah describing it's a piercing star, means the fire and the power that comes from that when it shoots out to these students whom are losing their mass and becoming more like stars. What happens? They get hit and overwhelmed by the heat, the tajalli, and they're overtaken by the hal that Allah is dressing them by. That's why I said they live by that. They, all their adherence is not from people, oh, you're like this, you're like this, they don't care for what people think of them. But for that center flame to reach them, they have to keep their good character. They have to keep their eyes clean, they have to keep their heart clean, they have to live a life of service and service in a grand way in which to continuously achieve the nazar of that center and that star that send your flares onto me so that it's continuously shooting out. The Najm al-Thaqib is continuously shooting out to them, dressing them, dressing them, dressing them. And this is the state of hal and emanation that the servant is reaching. And khash is that when they're moving towards that, Allah is giving them glimpses within their heart, visions and sights and knowledges and realities. When they speak, they see that talk. And this is from Allah's favors and rahmah and mercy. So it's the whole way is based on the muhabbat, the fana, the hudur, keeping the hudur first. So you can't reach fana without the hudur. That's why then if they don't enter into tafakkur, it's like they took one step because they came to the tariqah and they stopped. And then with the advent of all these social media is come to us, listen to me, listen to me, listen to me. Now they're not even stepping anymore into the center, they're going sideways like they're dancing now. They're bouncing from different YouTubes to different people, and you're not being distracted because you're not drawing near. No, I listen to this YouTube, it says don't do the meditation. No, you listen to this YouTube, I have to do this recitation. No, I listen to this YouTube, then the shaykh says this is a person is wasting his time, is wasting the shaykh's time, and they begin to lose the nazar of the shaykh. All they need to know is that you're stepping, you're breathing, you're practicing, you're entering into your fana, they don't need to hear from anything else. I want to do that, I want to recite this, I'm going to do like this, I'm going to watch this. You're a distracted individual. And now you're just jumping from line to line, you're not coming into the center. And that's what the shaitan wants, is to distract people so that they're not progressing. And Allah asked in Qur'an, have you seen those who made the ascension? That they came means they're coming into the center for realities, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Is it possible that the muraqabah changes how we feel energy in our body I feel it's become much more lighter and subtle.
I just gave you the whole talk check. You're asking questions after I give you answers. Said that if you lose your mass, of course you're going to have a different feeling of energy. If I send an energy, if somebody sends an energy and you're a very mass person, you just came in, you're full of dunya, you're not going to feel anything. But what happens if you lose your mass on the equation E equals mc squared? If the mass is brought down, the E equals two lights, nur and nar. Nur is a reflective light, nar is the burning flame of the Divinely Presence. The one whom losing their mass is of course going to continuously feel energies. So they become latif, and that's why we call latayif. The latayif are the subtle energies and energy points on the body, subtle, because you have to be latif. If you're not latif, you don't feel what energy came, what energy went. You're like, I don't feel anything. That's not a good state, that means your heart not alive. When your heart is alive and your mass dropped down, you feel everything. You feel anything trying to come around you, you feel the bad energy very pronounced, and you feel the beatific energies. But on this dunya there's more negative than good, so they feel the overwhelming breeze of negativity everywhere. Like walking through a storm of locusts, they're just hitting you from every direction because it's just the black clouds of difficulty and bad energy everywhere. So definitely if you lose your mass, you're going to feel the energies and all these realities. But it's good these people have these questions, but because of their questions the answers are already coming, because I presume they had their question before we started the talk. So it means that in their heart they put out what they want to know, and that's why these talks are now covering these subjects of what people want to know about energy, their condition and how to reach towards these realities inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Shaykh.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Shaykh, as a student in Al-Azhar University, wallahi 60 seconds of Shaykh Nurjan's knowledge is equal to 2 years of studying at Al-Azhar. We love you Sayyidi.
Thank you. Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. Allah bless you, pray for us inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, dear Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Is there a way to completely ignore shaq, bad desires and bad behavior?
Yes, we talked about that in your waswas and in your energy. So let's, the graphic example, let's say shaitan. Or you know, a bad or malicious energy like a bad jinn. The only reason he can come near me is why? Because his energy is not affected by me. So what does that tell you? Is that my energy is in a state that this bad energy has the ability to come right next to me and talk all he wants. Well, that's not a good sign. So then it tells me that I should be like a fighter. I have to now build my energy, I have to do my salawats, I have to do my awrad, and not just do the awrad but throughout the day I have to go to 1,000, 2,000, 10,000, 20,000 salawat. You have so much zikr to do, you really have, you know, no time. Throughout your day you have to be making salawats, have to keep praising, keep making istighfar, you meditate, you have to meditate so that you feel the presence of the shaykh, because your energy is not sufficient, these devils come too close to you. We said before, you reach a state when your energy vibration is so high that if they try to come into your field, your buzz and your alarm goes off because you're emanating with very high frequency energy. Your alarm system is an energy frequency. Anything entering into that frequency, they're picking up an extreme buzz. So there are devils that try to come towards them, whether they're awake or asleep, and the entire vibration of their being, an alarm will be set because that's not a vibration that's supposed to be in their field of energy. But until you get to that point, it requires continuous practice, and that becomes Ayatul Kareem, Qul Ja'al Haq wa Zahaq al-Baat. That say, oh, when the truth comes, the falsehood perishes. So this is all about light and energy. If you're emanating with these energies, with this zikr, and the heart is beating with the zikr of Allah, means your entire soul is vibrating at such a frequency that it makes a field of energy. So something very dirty and bad trying to come, you're immediately going to feel it. And something bad, bad intention immediately sends off an alarm, and then they're very aware something is trying to come close to them. So that's all based on energy, and the logical answer is energy. That's why the energy subjects are so easy to understand. And you make wudu for what? For sealing your energy. You make salatul wudu for sealing your energy. You do your wazifas, your salah and all your namaz, you do your internal zikr to kill the shaitan inside of you. When you've done and fortified all these energies, your madad and your meditation builds your frequency so that you become like that light that kills flies. You know, in summertime when there's too many flies, they put these electric lights, it makes a loud noise too, you can hear the frequency. And when the mosquito comes too close, it goes, it fried it. Same thing, the shaitans and this jinn, when they come too close to that energy, they're getting fried. Very few will progress to come in unless they're on a mission. At that time, then the madad of the shaykhs and all that support them, they come in and find out what's going on. So this is the whole system. So madad is also for building yourself, but madad is also your security force. So with all the madad and your life living a way of madad and humility, that, Ya Rabbi, that inna anta subhanaka inni kuntu minal dhalimeen, that glory be to you and I'm oppressor to myself. And Allah is the one who grants somebody a najat, that you're living a humble life, we will protect you. So then they do their good, and that which is out of their control trying to attack, because they live by their madad, Allah sends a support to make sure that they're safe and they're protected inshaAllah. So that's hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. So faith and trust in Allah is an action in which we have to do steps that show that we have our faith and trust in Allah. And for those whom completely put their faith and trust in Allah with this formula of muhabbat and ishq and love of Sayyidina Muhammad and those whom represent the ulul amr, when that formula is complete, they truly have faith and trust in Allah, and Allah's the greatest of those whom defend. So imagine Allah's defending, there's nothing to fear or to grieve. Allah's the one with all His izzah and might, Rabbul Izzah is defending them and protecting them. But if there's a deficiency in that relationship, which is going to be the love of Sayyidina Muhammad and that you must be accompanying the ulul amr. If you're not accompanying ulul amr, there's something wrong in that contract. So when they have all of that, then they feel the nearness and that safety of Allah inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Can the dua Ayatul Kursi help combat one's nafs and waswas, and can it be recited often?
Yeah, you can recite the ayat of kursi for protection once a day. Again, you can't circumvent making your connection. So if that's a question in which to avoid meditating, connecting and everything we talked about for 40 minutes, no. Because without the connection you make too many du'as, too many zikrs and you go crazy. So brings up a different energy and a different reality. So this is not about, and the gist of the subject, you know, it points out something that if you believe that you can do this and you're gonna fix this with awrads, then you're really relying upon yourself and very proud of the self. But if we didn't understand the whole discussion, is it's not about, because some people are very particular, well, I need this wazifa, I need this exact awrad, how do I do this? That's telling the doctor that, do you really think you're lifting yourself up? That if you miss one of the words and you miss this and you miss that, you were not able to like become like Shazam and now push everything away? It wasn't about you, you were supposed to say, I'm nothing, I'm zalim and I have now vanished. And for Allah's najat and salvation to come, you have to be nothing. When you're nothing, it's the madad that is important, it's the presence of the shaykh coming and making these energies to dress upon you. When that is solid and when that's strong, then you recite what they ask you to recite and that energy is then dressing the servant. But if they think, oh, I have problems, I'm going to recite this now 1,000 times, I'm going to recite that 1,000 times. If that's in place of making your connection and acknowledging I'm nothing, then that's not going to do much. Because what's coming to you is like a test, Allah keeps sending it and the person keeps thinking they're going to make themselves stronger and they're going to recite and go. But this wasn't about making yourself stronger in this sense. It was about becoming humble that I'm nothing, and then in my humbleness the madad is the strength that comes, because it's Allah coming, the love of Prophet coming, and then the love of ulul amr dressing you. That is Atiullah, Atiya Rasulu, ulul amri minkum. They came into the servant whom acknowledged their weakness and their nothingness. But if this was about each one trying to make themselves to be stronger, tougher, do more, then where did the madad come? And where does it come into that formula? And it doesn't, and it makes people to be proud of what they do and the actions and the amal that they do. And that's why you get so many people emailing, I'm doing this wazifa, I'm reciting this Qur'an, I'm reciting this, I'm doing that. But you do whatever you want, but the guidance was you were supposed to do your madad. You were supposed to do your connection, and with that connection you can build upon everything inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
What can we do for our parents that want to be cremated? Please forgive me.
What can you do for parents that want to be cremated? With parents is difficult because you can't say much to parents because you have to keep the respect of what people want to do. If you ever do get the opportunity and you know having a discussion about, you know, when you sleep and you have dreams and if imagine somebody puts a lighter under your foot when you're sleeping, do you think you feel it? And the person says, yeah, of course I'd feel it because I'm sleeping. Yeah, so well in my belief and what I understand, death is like a great sleep in which we're transitioning into a different reality. So what if you're going to feel that? And there's a chance I'm right and maybe chance I'm wrong, but if my chance of being right is right, do you really want to feel the pain or burn and for what? And usually, you know, maybe it's for financial reasons, this person doesn't want to pay for their grave and doesn't want to they come up with excuses, burden people. But you know, you can search everywhere for something affordable, there's insurance programs that people can put, or you know, many different ways to try to resolve that for somebody, in which to get a grave for them as a gift and say, I got a grave for you, and then I'm going to bury you here. I don't think you should, you know, play with fire, and you shouldn't have to try to feel pain and burning and want to vanish from this world. You have to have a place in which I can visit you and draw near to you, pray for you and remember you. Some people have had a difficult life and they feel that they should just vanish and burn their presence away from this earth. So there's many different reasons, but the putting in the grave and burning, and that's why as a Muslim it's important to prepare your grave ahead of time, that you have to buy your grave ahead of time. That's why we're doing this, because of the difficulty that's coming and the overwhelming expense of burials going up and up and up and not going down. And I have a feeling that it may go even higher because of the abundance of people entering into the grave. So it's going to be harder to find anyone, and before you know it they're going to offer, well, you got to burn this person, God forbid. So, and if you leave it and leave the burden to your children and they don't have that faith and they don't have the money, then they'll say, well, yeah, well, you know, you go to this funeral place, they say, well, you know, for a few $1,000 we can put him and burn him and put him in a cup. So we don't want to leave the choice to other people on our departure. Our departure is the most important element of our existence on this life, that we have to go quickly to the grave, we have to be washed and clean. We're about to meet, you know, the presence of Allah's Divine Delights and the love of Sayyidina Muhammad. We wouldn't want to leave that to other people to choose, so this is a part of planning, part of faith, and to get your place and go there and pray often that, Ya Rabbi, make it to be the abode of peace, make it to be the caravan of love, make it to be filled with the love of my awliya, love of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, love of your Divinely Presence. So these are all important steps in faith, and to convey that to some people that we love that would want to harm themselves, then it's in Allah's hands, and you keep praying to Allah to change their heart and change their mind, and whatever is possible, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
This question is from TikTok. Does TikTok not present more harm than good?
TikTok? All of them present immense harm, more harm than any good. We don't have any personal accounts on any of these social medias, nor should anyone have a personal account and out there enjoying these things. These are all demonic. We already have talks on all of these. These are all demonic playgrounds, but we're there to teach people. So we're on all these social media platforms to teach people. Don't direct message anyone, don't do any communications with people, don't go onto social media with personal accounts, make alias accounts, make SMC accounts, new Muhammad accounts, not your personal name and putting your personal picture and then direct messaging and talking and chatting with people and making every type of haram and every type of zina. This is not at all acceptable and very dangerous. So no, definitely over the years we have many talks on that subject. But if you think we're going to let shaitan be out there, just have free reign, no, absolutely not. Wherever they are, we're coming right in after them and sort of bombarding them with these missiles and these bombs of truth and bombs of light and love and ishq and the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. So that's, you know, for the benefit of teaching and da'wah. So that these people don't burn themselves with every sort of badness, and that becomes the reality. So when people make these accounts, it's very important to make a Nur Muhammad account. If you're on those platforms, take the reels, take the short videos and start sharing them like crazy everywhere so that they can't take down our site. Because as soon as we start posting, they start telling us, oh, you know, you don't meet our guidelines. And then I asked Ali, which guideline they're talking about? It was your video against smoking. So, what? I never heard that before. Our video against smoking, they came back and said it doesn't meet our guidelines because we want to destroy everyone and you're trying to help people. Who can come and say that that doesn't meet your guidelines? So it means we know that they're clever, they're going to try to maybe put this down or take this down, but if 1,000 people are putting out channels for Nur Muhammad, well, which one are they going to take down? That's what's important. Make it and send it out. Don't play with it yourself, don't play with fire, don't go in there and talking and chatting with people. You're going to lose your grace and proximity to Prophet. So this is about the da'wah in the last days. Same with YouTube channels, same with Instagram channels, all of these are for da'wah and sending out information and knowledges and reality, because you have to be where the people are. So if you say, I'm only going to sit here but everybody's over there, well, you have a message that's going to deliver to who? So wherever they are, we have to deliver that message and that reality. So like people on a busy area and there's someone standing on a soapbox and telling them, the last day, last hour is upon us, the last hour is upon us, is exactly like that. These people are so engaged in craziness, and here comes these teachings that the last hour is upon us, the doom is coming, difficulty is coming. They don't want to hear that. Not even the makers of that software, they don't want. They say, you don't meet our guidelines. Because we told people not to smoke. So you can see how crazy that this social media is, how dangerous these platforms are, inshaAllah. Allah protect us all, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum, Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Sayyidi, I'm concerned that nowadays 1 in 54 children is in autistic spectrum disorder, and ADHD is common among kids, some related to vaccines and some others to the bad quality of food and lifestyle. Does it have to do with jinn world? What is happening to the children in the world? Something is damaging the neurodevelopment of our kids. Could you please give us an explanation on how to protect our kids? Allah bless you.
Yeah, inshaAllah, these are the signs of the last days and the effect of energy, the effect of food, like everything you said, that's everything. The vaccinations and what they're putting within these different medicines and how it affects the heavy metals that they put within them and how it affects the body of the child, the mental development, the energy developments, all of these. And that's why it's so important that for families that Allah guides them to the tariqahs, that they wear the taweez, they put the taweez upon the children, that when having a child and what they eat and what they drink, and to make du'a upon everything. And what else can one do? Is if they did everything they could to be good with Allah and to be spiritually protected by what Allah has given as a ni'mat, then the rest is in Allah's hands. So we're in a difficult time, difficult area, and everyone's trying their best to survive through these difficulties. And what the believer can do is try their best, and whatever is in Allah's hands is in Allah's hands. But definitely for those whom are not paying attention and they're under extreme difficulty, because they don't pay attention to what's happening and what the children are doing, what type of energies will affect the children, what type of difficulties are in the food and in the drink and in the water and in their toothpaste. And you know, they put fluoride in Western countries in water and in toothpaste, and that's formaldehyde, and that has horrific effects upon the body and upon the mental development of children. So those things are dangerous, those are deadly. But you know, if people come to an awareness and use more homeopathic remedies and have more spiritual understandings, then people can at least traverse the difficulty of dunya, inshaAllah. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifoon, wa salaamun al mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Bi hurmati Muhammad al Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al Fatiha. Ameen. Ameen. MashaAllah, very good. Thank you very much. Very nice questions, alhamdulillah. Inshallah. Baniyat khatme khawchakan. Shaitan al-Radim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh.
25 times astaghfirullah. أستغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه إنه هو التواب الرحيم من كل ذنب ومعصية ومن كل ما يخالف دين الإسلام ومن كل ما يخالف الشريعة ومن كل ما يخالف الطريقة ومن كل ما يخالف المعرفة ومن كل ما يخالف الحقيقة ومن كل ما يخالف العظيم يا أرحم الراحمين يا الله اللهم يا مسبب الأسباب يا مفتح الأبواب يا مقلب القلوب والأبصار يا دليل المتحيرين يا غياث المستغيثين يا حي يا قيوم يا ذو الجلال والإكرام وأفوض أمري إلى الله إن الله بصير بالعباد رابطي شريف فاتحة الشريف 3 times Salawat al-Sharif 10 times. Surah Inshirah 3 times. Surah Ikhlas 3 times. Surah Fatiha 3 times. Salawat al-Sharif 10 times. صلي يا ربي وسلم على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آل كل أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين إلى شرف النبي صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه الكرام والأرواح مشايخنا في طريقة النقشبندية العالية خاصة إلى روح إمام الطريقة وغوث الخليقة شاه بهاء الدين نقشبند محمد ويسي البخاري وإلى مولانا سلطان الأولياء شاه عبد الله الفايز الداغستاني مولانا سلطان الأولياء سيد محمد ناظم الحقاني مولانا شيخ هشام القباني شيخ عدنان القباني شيخ محمد عادل وياقوت الخواص مولانا شيخ نور جان مير أحمدي عبد الخالق الغجدواني صاحب الزمان سيدنا إمام محمد المهدي عليه السلام روح الله سيدنا عيسى عليه السلام سيف الله سيدنا إمام علي عليه السلام ثم سيدنا أبو بكر الصديق سيدنا عمر سيدنا عثمان سيدنا إمام الحسن عليه السلام سيدنا إمام الحسين عليه السلام سيدتنا فاطمة الزهراء عليها السلام وسير وساداتنا والصديقين الفاتحة. حسبي ربي جل الله ما في قلبي غير الله نور محمد صلى الله لا إله إلا الله إلا له إلا له إلا له أنت الهادي أنت الحق ليس الهادي إلا هو حسبي ربي جل الله ما في قلبي غير الله نور محمد صلى الله لا إله إلا الله إلا له إلا له إلا له أنت الهادي أنت الحق ليس الهادي إلا هو حسبي ربي جل الله ما في قلبي غير الله نور محمد صلى الله لا إله إلا الله إلا له إلا له إلا له أنت الهادي أنت الحق ليس الهادي إلا هو حسبي ربي جل الله ما في قلبي غير الله نور محمد صلى الله لا إله إلا الله إلا له إلا له إلا له أنت الهادي أنت الحق ليس الهادي إلا هو حسبي ربي جل الله ما في قلبي غير الله نور محمد صلى الله لا إله إلا الله إلا له إلا له إلا له أنت الهادي أنت الحق ليس الهادي إلا هو حسبي ربي جل الله ما في قلبي غير الله نور محمد صلى الله لا إله إلا الله إلا له إلا له إلا له أنت الهادي أنت الحق ليس الهادي إلا هو حسبي ربي جل الله ما في قلبي غير الله نور محمد صلى الله لا إله إلا الله إلا له إلا له إلا له أنت الهادي أنت الحق ليس الهادي إلا هو حسبي ربي جل الله ما في قلبي غير الله نور محمد صلى الله لا إله إلا الله إلا له إلا له إلا له أنت الهادي أنت الحق ليس الهادي إلا هو لا إله إلا الله 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 لا إله إلا الله
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد حبيب الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد حبيب الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد نبي الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد نبي الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد خليل الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد خليل الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد نبي الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد نبي الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد صفي الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد صفي الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد شفيع الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد شفيع الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله عليه صلوات الله لا إله إلا الله محمد حبيب الله عليه صلوات الله والسلام
على بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب على يوم
الله 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 الله
Allah, 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 Allah,
حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل نعم المولى ونعم النصير لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم نعم المولى ونعم النصير لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم الله الله حق
الله الله حق الله الله حق الله الله حق الله الله حق الله الله حق الله الله حق الله الله حق الله الله حق الله الله حق الله الله حق الله الله حي 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 الله حي يا قيوم 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 الله حي
يا قيوم حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل نعم المولى ونعم النصير لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم يا هو يا هو يا دائم يا هو يا هو يا دائم يا هو يا هو يا دائم الله يا هو يا دائم الله يا هو يا دائم يا دائم يا دائم يا دائم يا الله يا حليم يا حليم يا حليم يا الله
يا
يا حافظ
يا حافظ يا حافظ يا الله
يا ستار
يا ستار يا ستار يا الله يا غفار يا غفار يا غفار يا الله
يا غفار
يا غفار يا غفار يا الله
يا جبار
يا جبار يا جبار يا الله
يا قهار
يا قهار يا قهار يا الله
يا فتاح
يا فتاح يا فتاح يا الله
يا فتاح
يا فتاح يا فتاح يا الله
يا رزاق
يا رزاق يا رزاق يا الله
يا ودود
يا ودود يا ودود يا الله
يا رحمن
يا رحمن يا رحمن يا الله
يا رحيم
يا رحيم يا رحيم يا الله
يا حنان
يا حنان يا حنان يا الله
يا منان
يا منان يا منان يا الله
يا ديان
يا ديان يا ديان يا الله
يا سبحان
يا سبحان يا سبحان يا الله
يا سلطان
يا سلطان يا سلطان يا الله
يا امان
يا امان يا امان يا الله
يا سلام
يا سلام يا سلام يا الله
يا الله
يا الله يا الله يا الله
انت الله
انت الله انت الله يا الله
هو الله
هو الله هو الله يا الله
هو الله
هو الله هو الله
يا الله حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل نعم المولى ونعم النصير لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل نعم المولى ونعم النصير لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم يا سيد
يا صاحب يا صديق يا رسول يا الله يا سيد يا صاحب يا صديق يا رسول يا الله يا سيد يا صاحب يا صديق يا رسول يا الله يا سيد يا صاحب يا صديق يا رسول يا الله يا سيد يا صاحب يا صديق يا رسول يا الله يا سيد يا صاحب يا صديق يا رسول يا الله يا سيد يا صاحب يا صديق يا رسول يا الله
حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم حسبنا الله ربنا الله
حسبنا الله ربنا الله حسبنا الله ربنا الله حسبنا الله ربنا الله حسبنا الله ربنا الله حسبنا الله ربنا الله حسبنا الله ربنا الله حسبنا الله ربنا الله
سيدنا المهدي
خليفة الله
سيدنا المهدي
خليفة الله
سيدنا المهدي
خليفة الله
أزهره الله
أجابنا الله
أزهره الله
أجابنا الله
أزهره الله
أجابنا الله
أيده الله
أجابنا الله
أيده الله
أجابنا الله
أيده الله
الله
أجابنا الله
نسأله الله
أجابنا الله
نسأله الله
أجابنا الله
نسأله الله
أجابنا الله
حسبنا الله
ربنا الله
حسبنا الله ربنا الله
حسبنا الله ربنا الله
حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل نعم المولى ونعم النصير لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم يا غالبا غير مغلوب
يا غالبا غير مغلوب
يا غالبا غير مغلوب
يا غالبا
غير مغلوب
يا غالبا غير مغلوب
يا شاهدا
غير مغيب
يا شاهدا
غير مغيب
يا شاهدا
غير مغيب
يا قاربا
غير بعيد
يا قاربا
غير بعيد
يا قاربا
غير بعيد
يا غالبا
غير مغلوب
يا غالبا
غير مغلوب
يا غالبا
غير مغلوب
حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل نعم المولى ونعم النصير لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم من شرف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى صحابه الكرام ولمشايخنا في طريقة النشبندية العلية خاصة شان نشبة محمد بن سعد البخاري سلطان الشيخ عبد الفايز دغستاني الشيخ محمد ناظم حقاني مولانا الشيخ هشام كباني الشيخ عدنان كباني الشيخ محمد عادل عبد الخالق الخوج الديواني صاحب زمان سيدنا محمد المهدي عليه السلام روح الله سيدنا عيسى عليه السلام سيف الله سيدنا عليه السلام ثم سيدنا أبو بكر الصديق سيدنا عمر سيدنا عثمان إمام الحسن السلام إمام الحسين السلام سيداتنا فاطمة الزهراء السلام وسائر ساداتنا الصديقين الفاتحة آمين يا رب العالمين إن شاء الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته to everyone have a good week and shall we see everybody back Thursday Friday Saturday إن شاء الله
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nur John. Thank you for watching the video that you're watching. Inshallah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh.
Eastern cultures use teas and herbs as an elixir of health and wellness. Rumi Rose Teas revives this ancient tradition with a collection of over 40 delicious hand-blended teas. Enjoy God-given health and wellness within every cup of Rumi Rose Tea. Order online now. Eastern cultures use teas and herbs as an
A Timeless Reality with Sheikh Nurjan Mirahmidi guides the reader in meditation, connecting the heart to a guide and to daily spiritual practices to understand the effects of positive and negative energy and to progress the reader in their spiritual awakening and the soul's connection to the world of light. The Divine's Ancient Timeless Reality. Order on Amazon.com. If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations go. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of divinely knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Sheikh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input. And with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, NurMuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Sheikh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been providing basic necessities to those most in need worldwide. There have been over 600 water wells established in rural communities across Pakistan already. We continue to support and maintain multiple orphanages, providing a safe haven for hundreds of orphans, encouraging a pleasant environment for them to flourish. There are now multiple food vans operating across many cities worldwide, with our many volunteers ensuring the needs of the most vulnerable are met. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings and go to MuslimCharity.com. Are you ever searching for what zikr to recite for a particular need? We bring to you the Muhammadan Way app, an all-encompassing Islamic guide, where you can find special du'as and prayers, as well as comprehensive Islamic teachings. Download this powerful app now on iOS and Android. Rising Sun of the West is an essential spiritual guidebook filled with invaluable knowledge of the soul and the Divine's most powerful guiding light, Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. The author guides the student through a comprehensive program of spiritual development and hidden realities of the soul. Available worldwide at Amazon.com. As heavenly beings, we are on an eternal pursuit of angelic power. This book invites the seeker to attune to the guides of heavenly knowledge and discover the essential techniques we need to acquire to increase our positive energy within. In Pursuit of Angelic Power, available now on Amazon.com.